Party and bullshit. All I wanna do. This party is too lit.
But tell them where it actually starts from.
It, Jamaica, Queens. My Jamaica. Mom, dad, shout out. That's where it starts. I was the intern at the Source. I developed the back issue system, basically created my own salary, interned for a few months, graduated to a writer. Years later, graduated to the music editor. 8 cover stories, controlled the Unsigned Hype situation, started Slaughterhouse as a group.
Cool.
It's a, did you hear this, what he just said? Did you hear what he just said?
Yes.
Those are my guys, man. Yay. Those are my guys. So shout out to Slaughterhouse. They're defunct now, but that was definitely one of the defining moments of my career.
Hey, hold on. When you say that, you just make it sound so easy.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
You get 4 guys, like superstar
right.
solo rappers, mm-hmm. and to make a collective like that, and to bridge a gap. How difficult was it?
The hardest part was lying to Joe Budden and Royce the 5'9". That was the hardest part. Because they were lightweight beefing with each other at the time. Not real beef, but they had like a little bit of static. So when I approached Royce about doing the... What I wanted to do was at the time that song Swagger Like Us came out. And every rapper was jumping on the beat. Mm-hmm. Just trying to make their own freestyles. I got sick of that, so I said, let me get 4 dudes together who would murder a beat so bad that nobody else would want to touch it and would be exclusive content to the Source. So I called Royce, and he was down, but when he asked me who else was doing it and I said Joe, the first thing out of his mouth was, what did Joe say? I hadn't spoken to Joe yet, so I lied and said, Joe said, if you don't have a problem, he don't have a problem. He said, all right, that's cool, because I never really was with that beef and shit anyway. But if he act up, tell him I'm going to smack him in the mouth. I was like, sure, Royce, that'll work. So then I went to Joe, told him the exact same situation, and he said the same thing. What did Royce say? I said, Royce said, if you're not beefing, he's not beefing. He said, you know what? That's cool, because I always thought that beef shit was corny. Matter of fact, I'm down, Mecc, I'm down. Give me Royce's number. And I started panicking. I didn't know whether they was going to talk and tell each other and find out that I was lying and then call me back beefing with me and each other. So I you know, was really fucked up. But after about 5 minutes of standing by the phone and sweating like a nigga at a white woman funeral, they never called back. And the group, only person who was off to the races was Crook. As soon as I asked Crooked Eye to do it, the first thing he said was, how many bars of death we spit? And he sent me back his 16 like that day.
Wow.
He was the only person who was like, everybody else took a little finessing, but it actually worked out well.
What about Joel?
Joel was down. He came on later on. They ended up doing a song with him, and that's how that whole thing just kind of came together. But the core members, I mean, not the core members, but the two dudes that had the finesse were Royce and Joe Budden. And after that, it kind of took off. And again, it's one of those moments in my career where I was able to actually impact and add to the culture as opposed to just critiquing it from the outside. So that was like a great moment. Cover stories are a great moment, but that's like something that I can always look at and say, I did that.
Now, before I give the ladies the floor, talk about making your own lane inside of the business and how important it was to do that, and the difficulty behind it.
First, you got to find out what you're good at. You can't fake the funk. Plenty of people will tell your mother, only your mother thinks that you're good at everything. You can't listen to her because she's lying to you. And there's going to be plenty of things that you can do, plenty of things that you can't do. But when I got to the Source, I just wanted to work there so bad. You know, it was like everybody knew the Source magazine growing up. That was, all I wanted to do was be there. I just had to figure out how to get in. They had a shit ton of old magazines in the back doing nothing. I figured somebody needed to get in here and do something with them. We had too many, so I figured we could sell them. That's Queens hustle. Shout out to South Jamaica, Queens. You sell what's sitting around, you figure out a way to sell it. So I figured out a way to sell it. I priced it out. And we got so many offers within the first month, I ended up paying my own salary for the year. So they really didn't have a reason not to hire. Wow. Make yourself, I guess the key to that is just try to make yourself invaluable. It's not going to be easy to do because almost everything has a value, but you got to put the paint where it ain't. And that may be a lane that's wide open because nobody wants to do that job. Not every job is sexy.
Yeah.
If the non-sexy jobs got more attention, we'd have a lot less terrible rappers.
Mm-hmm.
A lot less terrible comedians, a lot less ugly models, a lot less non-athletic football players. Like, we have everything we have is because that's the sexy job. Everybody wants to do the sexy job, but the shit that makes the wheels turn are the things behind the scenes.
Mm-hmm.
That's where you need to put the paint at. And those are the people that become invaluable because everybody needs one of those people on the squad.
A lot of rappers are always talking about they're so iced out, chains, rollies, all of that. But I see you got the real ice. You have some crystals. I'm really into crystals. Can you tell us about what you got going on here and if that helps center you?
Well, this is Thanos. This is Thanos Senior. pyrite, tourmaline, and blue calcite. Mm-hmm. Calcite for the throat chakra. Pyrite for the money. Tourmaline for protection. Few joints over here. Shout out to Stone and Shadow. Stone and Shadow makes all my jewelry. I am not religious, but I am spiritual. So if I'm gonna put my money someplace, let it be something that's gonna help me. I don't need to buy a lot of ice because my birthstone is diamond, so I was already born one of those. What the fuck I gotta wear one of those for? Sorry, I'm lying. But yeah, man, I like what I like, man. People follow trends like they chase clout, but those things aren't faithful to you.
Right. Talking about trends, what would you say, because there's a trend now, people getting into consciousness and all of that, especially at the Mercy Hustle. What would be a good advice that you give the brothers out there that
grow, get into everything, grow. You are not supposed to stay the same. That was a line that we had in the 90s. Don't change, never change.
Yeah.
No, nigga, no. Change. Grow up. Make moves. Nobody said you had to be a whole different kind of dude, but you're not supposed to be the dude you were 10 years ago.
Absolutely.
I'm not the dude I was 10 minutes ago.
Mm-hmm.
I picked up some new shit. I'm going to incorporate that. I talked to the ladies. I talked to Jack. I got a whole new perspective. Talk to the DJ. I talked to my man over here. I got a whole new... Talk to Vin Rogers. Turned around, he cracked the joke. I got a whole new perspective. You're supposed to pick shit up every day. It's not supposed to be the same shit. And if you're on a treadmill, you're going nowhere fast.
Yep.
That's the fast way to fail. You cannot be afraid of change. And if you're... Not all change is positive.
Yeah.
Not all movement is forward.
Yeah.
But if Nipsey is inspiring people to be anything like him, I'm here for every piece of
all of it.
I'm afraid I might run out of stage because of that.
Right.
Dude, get in, get everything under your belt. all of it. That's how I ended up being able to give advice on everything from marketing and promoting an album to how to pull off a successful threesome, to how to keep your how to keep your woman happy in the house, to how to keep your man satisfied in the crib. Like, and you speak in general statements, but I know how to argue with a woman. I don't argue. I try to get an understanding. My father told me real early, never be with a woman who wants to be right more than she wants to be happy.
Yeah.
If she's arguing with you, if she's arguing with you to win, walk away and don't look back. If she'd rather win than understand you, walk away and don't look back. Don't argue to win the fight. Argue to get an understanding.
Yeah.
So when I argue with my girl now, I'm trying to understand. I'm trying to figure out where she's coming from. I also told her, never think that anything I do is ever done to hurt you. You can't ever think it's my intention to hurt you. You start thinking that, we're going to fail.
Yeah.
I'm going to fuck up. I'm going to hurt you because you care about me. Because I'm under your skin now. So the things I do affect you differently.
Yeah.
I'm going to hurt you. But you can't ever think that that was my intention. You have to know that whatever I did that hurt your feelings, oh shit, I am so sorry. I had no idea. Otherwise, if you think it's my intention, when I apologize, you won't fucking believe me.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to be sunk. Vice versa. If I think you waking up in the morning talking about, what can I do to fuck Mecca's whole day up? Oh, this relationship is over. Get the fuck out. I'm evicting myself. Like, I'm about to go live on the Q train. Get the fuck away from me.
One more.
Are you afraid of anything?
An asterisk next to my name.
I love it.
An asterisk next to my name.
But why?
Because I'm afraid of not finishing.
Mm.
I'm afraid of not finishing. That would be failure to me. My biggest fear was my father passing away. And then that happened. So, you know, my mother's still here. I've learned to accept that. I deal with that. But my fear now is just not finishing.
How do you know you're finished?
I'll see you at the end.
What is your idea of being finished as a whole, spiritually, mentally?
When I can't think of anything else to do, I'm finished.
Mm. Hey, talk about the podcast, Eminem.
The Eminem show. Shout out to my co-host, Kay Levine. She's a fitness expert. She walks around making everybody look fat all the fucking time. We interview celebs. We interview porn stars. We interview comedians. We interview Jack Thriller. We talk relationships. We talk advice for artists. We talk advice for relationships. And we talk shit. So, if you're into any of those things, I got you covered. If you want something else, you're going to have to go someplace else because I don't have that shit. But all the other shit, I 100% got.
I love the show. I'd love for you to bring Jackie's Angels on your
show.
Oh, I'm going to need some more mics.
We don't need mics.
Hey, Mecca, I really appreciate you coming to Party and Bullshit, man. Is there anything you want to say to our platform before we get out of here?
Oh, yeah. Follow me over at Mr. Mecca on all channels. It's MRMECC. The Eminem show is doing this thing. Spotify all over the place. You can Google that shit. Stop judging and try to be nicer to each other. And go get laid. Go get laid.
Check us out.
Partying bullshit. This party is too lit.